Hello ladies, I wanted to talk with you specifically today, this video, yes, this is just for you. I wanted to talk with women out there that might be desirous of getting cold approached more regularly in their lives. And I wanted to just share some perspective from my experience about the things that I've noticed that's made it easier on me to want to walk up and cold approach a stranger and try to open up a conversation. These are just the things that I've noticed after doing this so long. I mean, there's certainly situations that make it easier on a guy to do this sort of stuff, and there's other particular facets of a woman's behavior when she's out in public that makes it very challenging and difficult. So I just wanted to share from a man's perspective just some things that you can do for yourself if this is something that you would like to have happen more in your life. And I think I get the sense that most every woman out there is probably a little bit frustrated that today's man, on the average, does not cold approach that much at all. And I can't tell you how many times, I mean, pretty much every woman that I've met under such pretenses over the last couple of years, like doing this cold approach stuff, they all react in the same way. They're just so beside themselves, and they're so just fascinated that, like, wow, guys actually do this stuff anymore? You actually, like, came up to a stranger and tried to open up, you know, some form of interaction, like a gentleman, like in a real world everyday setting, and you're not some guy that's just hiding behind an internet dating profile and trying to do everything online or everything through some alternative means. It's such a tremendous thing. And I know that, as I said, I can just speak for myself and the personal experiences that I've had, but every single woman seems to appreciate this so much. And I feel like there is this huge void out there in the world that I think both males and females want this stuff to happen more often, I believe. I think men want to learn how to do this stuff a little bit better, and that's a large part of the subject matter that I talk about here on the channel, is trying to equip and educate men to be able to do this stuff more readily. But it's a win-win. I think women, of course, win too when we have more men out there that are doing these sorts of things. I just think that it's healthier for everybody. And as I said, I know that women really appreciate this stuff when guys do it correctly, let's say. So with all that being said, I'm just focusing today on the behavioral traits that I've noticed that once again makes it easy on somebody like me to open up a conversation. And I just wanted to illustrate a little bit about some of the things that you ladies might be doing out there that you might be oblivious to, or you never really stop to think about this, but it might be holding you back. And if you are a woman, as I said, that wishes to get more readily cold approached in the world, you want to meet a man in a real world everyday setting, or even, let's just take this from the standpoint of even if you're out and about and you see somebody that you're attracted to, I want to give you a couple things that you can do that are well shy of you having to walk up and go open up the conversation and kind of be the man or the masculine energy in the situation. I don't expect women to do that, but there's certainly things you can do that will help your cause, or maybe solicit a guy's attention to get him to want to come over and talk to you or to open up something. So I hope all this stuff means something for you. I hope it helps you out. But let's just jump in and talk about these particular behavioral traits. So I just made a list, and these are just the immediate things that came off the top of my head when I was considering this video. The first thing I want to talk about is not wearing a ring on your ring finger. Now, obviously, I'm not talking about married women. I'm not talking about engaged women. You're obviously off the market, and nobody should be cold approaching you. I feel like that has half a brain or is a halfway decent person. But I meet so many women that they're wearing like a decorative, like a fashion ring or something, but they'll wear it on their marriage ring finger. And you might think that's innocent. You might think that guys, you know, are going to know the difference between a diamond, of course, and some other ring. But I think somebody like me is going to look at that as a big flag of unavailability, or at least it's going to cast enough uncertainty in the situation that you have no idea what that ring is all about. And it's going to be enough of a deterrent, at least in my mind, that I'm just thinking, like, well, you know, I don't know if that's a promise ring, or I don't know if it's a weird looking engagement ring, or I don't know what the deal is. But it's one of the most traditional things that women can do. Think about it, right? Is that ring finger, and having anything on it serves as a deterrent. So I know there's a lot of you ladies out there that you've got some sentimental something or other. You just maybe like the way it looks, or whatever your reason is for wearing it on your finger like that's all well and great. You can do that whenever you want, but I'm just saying, if you're going to go out and, you know, you're trying to meet people, like, think about maybe just replacing that ring to another finger or leaving it home today, because it is such a big deal. It's one of the very first things that I look for as a guy. And if you go back and listen to every single one of my cold approach videos that I've made for males, I mean, that's the first stage that any guy is going to go through, is they're going to analyze, they're going to look at these very big things that women are doing or the qualities they're exhibiting. And that, I've said it so many times, that's the first thing that I look at, is I try to get a good look at her hand. Is there a ring on her finger? If I see anything there on that ring finger, like, I don't even entertain the thought. I just keep on moving. I keep walking. I keep going, kind of thing. So, yes, that's part of the initial read, and you don't want to deter somebody before they ever get out of the starting gate with you if you're looking for this stuff. So that's number one. So no rings on the ring finger. Number two is you have to dress up just a little bit. Now, no, I'm not saying going out of the house every single day looking like, you know, you're going to, you know, you're going out on Friday, Saturday night, whatever, in your best outfit. You know, you don't have to put a dress on, you don't have to put heels on, you don't have to completely do your makeup, but you have to compose yourself a little bit, because once again, there's this psychological thing that men are going through. I think we as guys know that when a woman goes out of the house looking her best, it's almost like a signal, and this is like a primal instinctive thing, I think, that, like, she is doing that for the reason of wanting to attract attention from males. Now, maybe it's just, maybe she's married and she just takes good care of herself and she wants to go out and feel good about herself, but certainly there's that element tied to it, where I think for a lot of women, for them to feel good about themselves, they have to know that they're attracting the eyes and the attention of the opposite sex. I mean, that's just by nature who we are, right? Males are very visually driven. Females are just the ones in society that they typically look the best, and that's just the way that it's set up. So for, you know, a woman that goes out of the house, you know, without putting any care or thought to that, that actually kind of communicates the other sort of message. It's like, no, I don't want attention today. I don't want your eyes on me. I'm not looking for that today. So therefore, I haven't composed myself. I haven't put myself together. And don't get me wrong, you know, if you need to go down the street and grab a carton of eggs or something, and you got stuff to do today, and, like, you don't care about meeting anybody today, like, hey, that's fine. I'm not saying that women need to look their absolute best every waking moment in life, but I'm just making this connection here that if you are wanting to meet somebody, it's kind of like, put your best foot forward. Like, do a little bit of your job as a woman, let's say, to put a little bit of effort into your looks, because all that I'm telling you here is that it is kind of like it's putting up a little bit of a wall for men. It's because guys just know this stuff. A girl that's not at least a little bit put together, it's kind of like you start to feel like she doesn't want to be approached, or she doesn't want to be talked to, or she's not interested in that today. And sometimes that may be the case a lot of days, sure, but there's other times, I'm sure, where you're like, yeah, I'd love to meet somebody today. But if you don't do a little bit of that work to put yourself together and make yourself look somewhat presentable, then it's just it throws things off. I hope what I'm describing there is making sense to you ladies. And I want to say also, I think that it's funny, we live in this such politically correct time where, like, you can't say some of these things to some people and it just doesn't resonate. But I am telling you, this is straight from the horse's mouth. Every single man on the face of this earth thinks these same things. Like, we are visual creatures. That is the first thing that attracts us about a woman. You can hate that, you can love that, you can think that's right, you can think that's wrong, but I'm just telling you, that is reality. That is what guys are looking for initially. So this is kind of stating the obvious, like I said, but yes, if you want to attract a man to cold approach you, you know, just look somewhat presentable. All right, so the next thing I could come up with is no headphones. You have your headphones in your ears, and you look like you're in your own little world, and you're rocking out to your beats, or you're doing whatever. Once again, it's a wall. This should be obvious to people, but that's going to serve as a deterrent. A guy's going to think, you know, she might not even be able to hear me if I walk up and try to articulate some sort of opener, or she's probably really into what she's listening to right now, and I don't want to bother her. It's just, it's a small thing maybe, but don't have your headphones plugging up your ears when you're around there, or when you're out and about walking around. A similar thing to that same note, don't be so glued to your phone. Keep your head up, your eyes looking out. You know, you're not in cell phone land. You're alert to the world all around you. You're open and receptive to what's going on in your environment. Same sort of thing with the headphones. When you're glued down into your phone, a guy is just thinking that you're really busy. Maybe you're doing a work email, maybe you're doing any number of things, but it's kind of like a, in my mind, it becomes sort of a rude thing to walk up and interrupt somebody when they look like they're so intently concentrating on whatever they're doing. And the sad thing is, like, most girls that I see doing this sort of stuff, it's like they're doing something not important. They're doing something ridiculous. I see you flipping through Instagram. I see you on Facebook. I see you doing whatever, looking at purses on Etsy, looking at Pinterest. I mean, come on. Is that really more important than these hours in your day when you are out in public and you are out amongst other people and you are in settings where you could meet a guy, where you could solicit attention, and you're doing something stupid like that? It just serves as a deterrent. You know, you can do that stuff at home. You can do that stuff later when you're alone at your apartment at night or your house or whatever. You can do that, you know, at any other time of the day, but try to keep consciousness of that. Don't be glued to your phone. Another one that comes to mind is when you are out there walking, walk a little bit slowly, you know, slow your roll. If you're on a mission, you know, you're charging everywhere, you're walking fast, same sort of thing. It's hard for a guy to find a break in a moment where, you know, you're stationary enough that you are in a position where you could be approached. I mean, I know most women probably don't think about this stuff, but I challenge you ladies out there, try to stop somebody dead in their tracks when they're walking down the street, like strutting fastly, and just see how hard that is to do. It's a big challenge. Once again, it kind of goes to the whole, like, I think most people are trying to be polite, not trying to be rude. And if you get the feeling that somebody's on a mission or they're up to something, you know, today, and you know, that's fine if you are, great. You know, if you got somewhere to be and you're in a rush, then go for it. But if you got some time, you're just strolling through the grocery store, you're just taking a walk through the park, you're just doing whatever, slow down a little bit, walk slowly, maybe take a pause and smell the roses here or there, or take a look at something, or just, you know, just slow your gait down. This should be obvious stuff, but I think it's overlooked once again. But the whole concept of when you're in motion and when you're moving, and the more that you're in motion when you're out there in a setting where you might want to be approached like this, it makes it hard on guys to do it. And the last one is, this is probably the biggest thing that women can do for men out there to let them know that it's okay, or this is that scenario that I kind of touched on earlier in the talk, where if you actually see a guy that you would like to talk to, even yourself, or you're trying to solicit his attention, this is the biggest thing that you can do, is just put yourself in proximity. I'm not saying go walk up to the guy and tap him on the shoulder, but what I am saying is just put yourself in his visual range. Put yourself, let's say, within a 10-foot bubble, even, or a 10-foot space gap, let's say, to the point where you make yourself accessible. I mean, you know, it's going to be hard. He might not even notice you if you're clear across the room, or, you know, way across the aisle in a shopping mall, or any number of ways that a situation like this could present itself. But that's the biggest thing that you can do, is just walk past his radar. Put yourself in proximity. And, you know, same thing to kind of piggyback on what I said before, don't just walk through very briefly and quickly, like brisk past this person. That's not what I'm talking about. Slowly walk through the radar there, like I'm talking about. Slowly put yourself in proximity, hang out there for a few minutes. You know, give like a little break in time or a little opportunity for the guy to do something. That's just going to make it so much easier and smoother, and it is kind of a green light. I think most men probably know this stuff subconsciously, and it's not till they actually slow down and think about some of this stuff that they really understand what this means. But I think Some girls are really good at this and they understand this concept, but a lot have no clue or have never stopped to think about this. But once again, as a guy, that's kind of like a green flat or a green light or a good indicator that a woman is okay with you possibly opening her up and having a talk with her, trying to approach her. It's just this proximity piece. It's such a big deal that if you do nothing else, I encourage you ladies to do that. If you are, like I said, in a setting where you see a guy or you think that they're, you want him to cold approach you, just make it easy on him. The proximity piece is huge. So, well, that's all I can think about for today. I'm sure there'll be some other things that come to mind over the course of time as I reflect a little bit more on this. And by all means, if you ladies have some insight, feel free to leave some comments down below there and share with me and continue to educate me on your behavioral traits that you think that you can exhibit to solicit this sort of cold approach attention from males. So that's all I've got for today. Hope you ladies and everybody out there listening are having a wonderful day. We'll talk to you real soon.